Okay, very good morning. Now we are going to conclude the topic transposable element of a G-image. You all aware that the in previous lecture we have started this chapter, this particular new chapter in which Barbara McClintock has a very important contribution. And now we are going to extend the discussion as far as the former lecture is concerned. Already given this idea that there is an observation, particularly you might also observe that there are several images, cons, and in that you will find the different colors are there. The brown or purple color or colorless or yellow, such kind of varieties of things are there. This is a very surprising thing that within a one particular cone of this particular cone, why the differences are there, why the mosaic patterns are there, why the different colors kernels are there. And for satisfying the curiosity as far as these extraordinary observation, Barbara McClintock has discovered the transposable element first in case of a pawn. Henceforth, historical developments are also we are discussing as far as this chapter is concerned. Already I have given that you particularly focus as far as the double fertilization is concerned. In case of a plant, the concept of double fertilization is very well known to you. In previous lecture I also explained to you, within that the second fertilization, that is the when the sperm and secondary endosperm means N, sperm nucleus consists of the single cell and secondary endosperm nucleus consists of the two cells. Whenever combined, then forms a 3N, and this endosperm is the triploid one, and that resulted these things. Okay, but as far as this single seed is concerned, it's okay. For the different in another kernel another pattern is there, in another kernel another pattern is there. Why such kind of differentiation are there, that Barbara McClintock want to know. And in that she has conducted a series of experiments that also I explained to you, that the in a normal female plant flower which consists of the CC ear, CC C locus is the encoding for the color, and C prime is the inhibitor of the color, coloration is get inhibited. And when such a cross is there, there is a triploid endosperm which receives the two alleles from this particular female flower plant, because it is a part of that particular ovary, and C prime which is coming from the pollen grains. And hence go here, due to this C prime there is an inhibition as far as the coloration is formed. Hence go the kernel is yellowish, otherwise it is a whitish, white or yellowish color is considered as a lack of color. Why such kind of things have happened, that at molecular level I will explain that there might be a possibility that the one region, that is a D region, that get a detached, and if it get a detached, then automatically the color inhibition capability is get a loss, and hence for CC and without a C prime, now the colored things are. But although the brownish color, purple color is there, but it is not uniform one. Several color kernels are the colored, several are colorless, several are showing the mosaic pattern. Then question arises, why such things? First thing is clear that the C prime is getting detached. And for that purpose, she has discovered the various things. And now we know that the C prime is the dominant allele, which is the inhibitor. Whenever it is present, the kernel are colorless. C is the recessive gene which is the present on the exact same position, that is on chromosome 9, and whenever it is present the color is there. For the purple color BZ gene is there, for the brown color B capital small BZ is there, BZ is the capital BZ is the dominant, and this is the recessive. Then D is the part particularly which is contribute for the breakage as far as the chromosomes are concerned. But along with that, Barbara McClintock also proposes that there may be possibility of AS element, and henceforth AS are important, but exact location is not known. that should find the difficulty as far as the location is concerned. I suppose up to this particular things we have cleared our concept. Now, on the basis of Barbara McLean talk, whatever outputs are given as far as experiments are performed, today we are aware that in a maze, transposons are present, and that is popularly known as ACDS family. AC is the abbreviation of activator element, and DS is the abbreviation of the dissociation element. Both are the DNA, both are the segment of the DNA, and AC is defined as it is intact. Intact in the sense complete. Intact and active version of the transposon which is found in the maze, while DS element, dissociation elements, are the defective. They are not a complete one. And these are the transposon. These are also detected in the maze, but only problem is that they can't move alone. They need the help of AC element. Then and then they can transfer from one location to another. Then what is the characteristic feature? The characteristic feature of AC and DS family transposon is that they at the end they possesses the inverted terminal repeat of 11 base pairs, and then insert at 8 base pair target sequence is there, and at the end 11 base pair inverted terminal repeat sequence. Just keep in mind this word. I will explain this, what is actually the inverted terminal repeat is concerned and how it is contributing for the transposition when we are going to learn regarding to the bacterial transport. Then we are also aware today, due to the genetic sequencing explanation, all this thing, that the AC element consists of the 4563 base pair long, and it is a fully functional. What I am saying there, fully functional, that you encode for the important enzyme that is referred as the transport. While the DS elements are the vary in size, they are always less than, because actually the inactive version of AC element is the DS element. The DS elements are not individual, they are coming from the AC. Whenever the mutations takes place, then the defects are takes place, and automatically it becomes the DS. And so their size is always less than 4563, but it is not constant. In different region, different sizes are there, and so the sizes vary. They are derived from the AC already, you know, due to the deletion of the part. And what is actually deleted? Important gene encoding capability of AC element, that is the transposase gene expressing capability, is getting deleted. And henceforth, due to this, they can't move themselves, because for the moment, for the transposition purpose, the transposase enzyme is necessary. Means D can transfer from here to there, but for that purpose, there is a requirement of transposase enzyme, and transposase gene will be only active whenever the AC gene will be there. And so for the moving, the DS element, AC elements are important. If the cell contains AC element anywhere, because it is not required that AC should be comes close. It is a trans relation as far as these things are concerned. So wherever it might be present, it codes for the transposase, and that transposase is available. They systematically cut the DS. Henceforth, if the cell contains AC element anywhere in its DNA, then transposase enzyme is made by that AC and move DS element. Henceforth, with the help of this transposase enzyme, D element can be go here and there. Okay, so that the story. Previous lecture also I explained to you that this is the typical structure of AC element. This is the inverted repeat at present at the end. This defines that this particular area is the transposable element, and that is sandwiched the important gene, that is the transposase gene. Inverted repeat, transposase gene, and inverted repeat. Now, along with that, the target site is also there. Once again, I am going to hear this concept in the bacterial transposable element. But here you have to just keep in mind that this is the complete structure, and this is referred as a AC element. So what happens due to the deletion mutation, the transposase gene either gets inactivated or removed out, whatever. So in that way, the transposase gene is not working there, and henceforth, whatever things which is generated now, this is referred as the DS element. There is no much more difference as far as AC element, because inverted repeats are there. Here also inverted repeats are there. Only thing is that the transposase gene is getting defective, it get detached, means without, in absence of, means for, there are different combination of DS elements are here. The position is changed, but the partially the gene is get inactivated, means for there is no transposer gene and there is a complete loss of this. All are the DS element. Henceforth, although we can define these particular what how many base pairs are there, that is clear. First, 4563, but here there is a less than that. Okay, so that is the thing associated with the DS element. Henceforth, DS elements are always coming as a resultant of AC element after the deletion. Also, we are aware that that is not only the cusp-adjacent is the 11 nucleotide base pair inverted repeat at the end. Okay, the here you can say that the major portion is get missing part is not defined always. Any part here, this part is also get miss. Here part, this part also get miss. Means different parts are get made, and due to that there is a reduction in size. And in sport, DS elements are always as the smaller size as far as AC elements are concerned. Okay, so that is the more clear structure as far as the these things are concerned. Okay, then these DS element can be inserted as a inverted also. Okay, this is also important characteristic feature of the transposable element, that the by both the direction they can insert due to the inverted repeat. This is also very important concept I will going to explain during the vector transposable element. And so now what is clear to us today, based on the Barbara-McClintock theory and whatever experiments which are performed by later on stages after the sequencing all these things, it is known to you that there is a AC DS elements are there, and they are not need to be present on the same chromosome for the transposition of. Even the DS element can move from here to there, well, for that purpose ACs should not close to it. It should, if AC is present on another chromosome, still I given the importance that AC encodes for the transposase enzyme, and within a cell if it is produced, then if the transposase is available, then DS can transfer from here to there. If the DS element has inserted into gene for the purple kernel of the corm, the gene is disrupted and kernel are the white. Now suppose the transposase gene is there and DS elements are there. And in this DS element, if the DS element is get detached from its original position and get inserted into the gene which encode for the purple, a small BZ in former lecture if you recall, if it is inserted, so what happens due to that purple color forming gene get inactivated, and henceforth due to the insertion of the this particular D, the kernel become a white or yellowish. That is the referred that is the due to the insertion. Separation is mediated by the C prime, but the whether it should be working, get detached or not should get detached, that is decided by D, and D itself can also goes into the different positions. Suppose if it is get incorporated into the gene which is encoding purple kernel, then automatically it will. If there is no AC element, suppose if AC element is not there, then the entire corn kernel of the white is stably inherited. Now D is gone in the particular gene, henceforth that function is get but now here the D will be remain static when the AC element is not there. Suppose AC element is there, then the D can transfer from here to there, but you already I have given the idea that the without a cooperation of AC, without a transposer enzyme, D are not there. Henceforth, if the AC is not there, then they are remain as it. But suppose AC element is present in the some cell or the corner, and that is within a cell, that is a different kinds of different mutations are going to be. Then wherever the AC element is there, that contribute to move the D element. Means from that particular thing, it can goes, it can relocate its position. And so once again, the purple color is regained by that kernel, or other possibilities are also there. Okay, and so all the daughter cell means this happens in case of initial thing, and later on stages so many cells are generated, and whenever the daughter cells are generated, it should be the purple. Okay, if AC elements are there, but this is not like the different patterns are there, that these patches of purple are appear in the as kernel goes, and if the transposition occur when the kernel is just beginning to develop, means during the development also cells are growing, at that time also transposition frequency is there. Means for transposable element in presence of AC, they are changing the location of DS element. They are either inactivating the brown colored gene or they are inactivating the purple colored gene, and in that way they are responsible to confer the different color as far as kernels are concerned. Here very simple example has given. For example, this is the chromosome and which consists of the color. Now D comes here, due to the incorporation gun, this gene is get becomes a defective, from where the typical purple color will not seen. Means this becomes a white kernel, this is the one. But due to the AC presence, the D can go here, there, different position, and depending on that pattern, the different mottled kernel, mosaic kernels are get formed, and this is appear due to the continuous generation. Means this is when the this particular fertilization takes place. Initially, it is the single cell is germinate, a single cell is formed. The triploid zygote, which is a form about the endosperm, this is the single cell. Then these are the going to divide, and while dividing, different mitotic divisions are takes place. And during the mitosis, depending on the D, depending on the coordination of the C prime C, these different color combinations are there. Henceforth, the difference of this particular pattern is due to the change in the location of a several segment, and in this case in the mesh, particularly AC and DS, these are the two things are there. The here the AC is also changing its position here to there, and DS is also changing the position, but the for the changing the position of DS, AC is necessary. And henceforth here you can find that within in the first cells, for example, this is the thing. Then in another cell, due to the incorporation of D cell, the inactivation is taken. In the third cell, means during I am talking about the resultant daughter cells. So such pattern is there. And means for typical mottled, this is referred as the mottled because typical patches are there as far as the colored things are concerned. So this indicates this gene, which is the white one, and this indicate the presence of active gene. And but due to the different position, different mosaic mottled kernels are get formed, and that particular curiosity, that particular things which is explored by Barbara McClintock in 1940, and today we know, and this is a very important discovery. Why? Because formerly we are viewing the chromosome as a static one, there is no changes except the mutation. But later on, we capable to know that it is not like that. A intact unit, a discrete unit, a complete unit, a complete fragment of the DNA can translocate, can get inserted into another position, and it can remain moving. And henceforth, due to this also, the changes as far as expressions are concerned, whatever we are seeing, that the expressions are the modified, and these modified expressions are due to the dislocation of several fragments of the chromosome, and henceforth it is very important discovery. Later on, it is also confirmed that the transposable elements are also detected in other organisms, and particularly in bacteria also they are detected, and henceforth these are we are going to concentrate our attention towards the bacteria because we are the microbiologists. Just for the interest, we have collected the information regarding to the maize, because these are the two significant things associated as far as the maize transposable elements are concerned. Although it is a part of botany, but still purposefully we have studied it because historical developments are associated with this. These are the first transposable elements discovered. And later on, scientists have discovered detected the various transposable element in case of in other organism, and particularly whatever bacterial transposon, whatever viral transposons are there, particularly with the case of bacteriophages, that we are going to discuss in the coming lecture. So that's all regarding to the today's lecture. If you have any question, you can ask me. Yes, we have a lot of time today because we have completed this particular time and I am not going to start a new topic. We are going to start a new topic in next lecture. Next book, if you have any question, you can ask first. Otherwise, I expect that somebody should explain the slide. Those who have the very good connection, Madhuri or Ritul, Chanchan is also there. Whoever has a good connectivity, you have to, I expect that you should explain the particular slide one by one. Okay, this is very important that I want to expect from you. Read out and possibly if it is possible then also explain. Anybody? Hello? Aditya? Whether it is possible to you to read out this slide?
Yes, sir.
Okay, please.
Dominant allele on the short arm of chromosome 9 that prevents color form being expressed in the alurine layer of the maize kernel, causing a so-called colorless phenotype, which is initially white or yellow in color. This is also known as the inhibitor allele.
Okay, this means simply means that the C prime is the dominant allele first thing, and whenever it is present, it suppresses the color formation. Means it is called the colorless phenotype. Colorless in this case, yellow or a white kernel. Okay, very good. Next sentence.
Recessive allele on the short arm of chromosome 9 that leads to a color development.
Okay. One thing always keep in mind that these are the allele. Their position is always the same. Wherever the C prime is present, equivalently same position the another C is present. Henceforth, the position is same and these are present on the chromosome 9 in the short arm. Okay. But this is the recessive one and it is the functioning color. It or whenever it is present, it is a give the typical color. What kind of color? For that purpose, the genes are there. The alleles are identified. That is with the case of BZ. Okay. Read about the BZ.
BZ, it is a dominant allele on the short arm of chromosome 9 that leads to a purple phenotype.
Okay. That encodes for the purple color. And all are present on the chromosome 9 and the short arm. This is also important. Okay, then what about the small bz? Small b?
Small bz, it is a recessive allele on the short arm of chromosome 9 that leads to a dark brown.
Okay, it encodes for the brown. Okay, and it is dominant. Means whenever the B, capital BZ and small bz both are present, the color will be, which color will be formed? For example, in the any things, if the heterozygous BZ and BZ both are present, then which color that kernel will form? Brown or purple?
Purple.
Other can also be the answer. Yes, Madhuri?
Purple.
Why purple?
Purple.
Why purple?
Sir, because BZ is dominant allele.
Very good. That always, whenever two genes are there, always this is the dominant gene is expressed. This is the recessive transpose. And whenever BZ and B, if the small BZ, both the genes are present, then what will happen?
Dark brown color.
Small BZ. When present, then what will happen?
Dark brown.
Dark brown. Why dark brown? Because there is no presence of the BZ. Very good. Okay. Now, explain about the DS. What is the DS, Aditya?
DS, it is a genetic location on the short arm of chromosome 9 at which chromosomal breakage occurs.
Okay. This is the particular part from which the fragmentation of chromosome takes place. I also showed this particular thing as far as the diagrammatic view is concerned. Okay. Here this is the C and here this is the D. D is the part from where the chromosome can get detached. Hence it is referred as the D. Okay, what is A?
A is a factor of unknown location, at least when McClintock was conducting her research that impacts the expression of DS.
Okay, she can't capable. She detected the D, she detected everything, but she couldn't establish that where is the AS. Okay, that also gives that the location is not perfect. But whatever that the to in order to execute the functioning of D, a contribution of AS is important. But during a genetic mapping experiment, she can't locate where it is actually. Okay, Hanensko. If suppose if it is present on other another chromosome also, still it has the effect, because only the only function of the AS is that it encode for the enzyme transposes, and without a transposes enzyme, D is not relocating its position. Okay, this slide, who is going to discuss? Chanchal or Madhuri or Shruthika, whoever. Hello. Hello, Yogesh. Yogesh is there?
Hello.
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 Hi, Yogesh.
Yes, sir.
Can you give me a comparison between AC and DS element? What is means AC? What is means DS? What is the long form? What is the role? Major thing are in front of you. Current slide is the same thing. You have to just one by one, you have to explain me a difference. Yogesh? Or anybody else?
Yes, sir.
Okay, who is going to explain? I think this online learning should offer you a comfort. तुम्ही पाहिजे त्या स्थितीमध्ये ऐकून लेक्चरला उत्तर देऊ शकता, त्यामुळे तुम्ही द्यायला पाहिजे उत्तर. जर स्पीड एवढाच प्रॉब्लेम आहे, बाकी काही प्रॉब्लेम मी तुम्हाला दिसत नाही, तुम्ही मला दिसत नाही, म्हणजे दिसू शकतात तुम्ही पण तुम्ही दिसत नाहीत मला. यस,
एसी इट इज अन इंटॅक्ट अँड ऍक्टिव्ह व्हर्जन ऑफ ट्रान्सपोजन फाउंड इन एज बिकॉज इट हॅज ट्रान्सपोजेस ऍक्टिव्हिटी विच मीन्स इट कॅन जंप फ्रॉम वन पोझिशन टू अदर, व्हाइल डीसी इज डॅमेज्ड वन. Which is also known as dissociative element. It requires the activity of AC and it cannot move by itself.
Whether the DS element encodes for the transposase enzyme?
No, sir.
No. AC element encode for the transposase enzyme?
Yes.
Whether the AC and DS has the same terminal repeat or they have different terminal repeat? The terminal repeats of AC and DS are the same or different?
Same, sir.
Same. And what about the size? Whether you can give the information regard to size, what is the size of AC and what is the size of DS?
AC element is 4563 base pair
long. And DS element?
DS elements varies in size.
Okay, they are varies, but their inverted repeat sequence is the same. I think that is the this concept might be clear. Actually, AC from AC the DS elements are generated, and for that a mutation, deletion mutation is contributing. Okay, whether it is possible to convert the DS into AC? DS can once again converted into AC element?
might be if there is a repair.
Not repair, but as a part of a consequences, mutations are takes place, and particularly these DS might go here and there, and there are chances that DS once again becomes a AC and once again become the DS. Okay, this is the vice versa continuously going to. Very good. I think you have achieved the whatever understanding is concerned. I am not sure regarding to other, but still I suggest you to listen sharply as far as these videos are concerned. You are lucky that later on also you can make a revision. Try to have your own notes. Also refer books. I have given so many books to you. Even today also I have forwarded several books to you. And prepare this particular paper, where this is very easy one also, and also which is important as far as the future your study is concerned. Okay, in next lecture we are going to discuss bacterial transposable element in the next. Henceforth, that is sufficient for today. We will meet in the next lecture. Okay, you can also brought, or meanwhile also you can send me your questions. If you have any question, if you want any clarity as far as any topic is concerned, if you want any revision, that is also possible for me. And henceforth, prepare, dedicate yourself as far as studies. Okay then, bye bye.